As you remember, Objective-C is pretty blasé about its handling of nil values. Like Dizmir mentioned, by default, any object can be nil in Objective-C. From Swift's perspective, the danger of nil values lurks around every corner. If your Swift code is consuming Objective-C code, you need to be constantly checking for nil values. Unexpected nil values that are handled incorrectly can crash your app. To see how an unexpected nil value might get passed to your Swift code, let's take a look at how Objective-C gets translated into Swift by default. Let's say we have an Objective-C class that represents a user. Our user class has properties representing a user's name, email, and avatar. And down here, we have an initializer that takes two strings as parameters, but doesn't take an avatar. Not every user has an avatar. If we click on this icon in the top left corner, down at the bottom of the menu, we see this option for Generated Interface. Clicking that option gives us the interface that's generated for Swift. So, okay, we've got some Swift code now, and we see name, avatar, and email, along with the init method, but we also see a lot of exclamation points. By default, Swift treats every variable coming from Objective-C as an implicitly unwrapped optional. As we know, implicitly unwrapped optionals are dangerous. We don't want to be accidentally unwrapping nil values.